Welcome to Tips and Tricks for Research. My name's Sylvia and I'm a librarian. I can show you a few things that may help with your research. In this video tutorial, I'll outline some important things to keep in mind when you're evaluating a website or web page. To Google or not to Google? That is the question. Okay, let's get real here. It's just easier to find things online. And in some cases, some professors will let you use one internet resource. So in the case it's the night before the essay's due and you want to use one internet resource for your paper, here's what you can watch out for so you don't use a website with bad information. Use the following criteria. Check for authority, accuracy, currency, objectivity, and coverage. When looking at websites, the first thing you should look for is the authority. Ask yourself, what is the purpose of the website? Try to find an about page to learn more about the purpose of the site or the organization. Also ask, is it a personal website or an organizational website? A personal website may need a closer look. Look at the credentials or information about the author or authors of the site. A professor in sociology that discusses the culture and impact of social media will be more credible than a teenager's blog on why social media is awesome. Also ask, what's the URL? You can also look at the URL or the ending on a web address to understand the purpose of the website. For example, a URL with .gc.ca is a Canadian federal government website. .gov is usually used by the provincial government. .com usually indicates a commercial site. .org is usually used for nonprofit organizations such as United Nations. And in the US, .edu is used for educational institutions. Another criterion to consider is the accuracy of the information. Ask yourself, is the information right? Of course, it's always hard to tell if you don't know much about the topic, but here's how you can verify that information. Look at the course readings and texts and verify basic information. For example, I found a website that discusses botulism. It writes that there are four types of human botulism. When I refer to the course assigned readings and compare the information, I see that the information is correct. The other criteria is the currency. Try to find a date on the website to see if the site has been updated. A site that has not been updated for 5 years is most likely not monitored or an abandoned site. For example, this website shows that even though it was created in 2001, it has been reviewed in 2006. The other important criterion is objectivity. Ask yourself, does the writing sound biased? Are there advertisements? If the writing seems informal or opinionated, then chances are the content may be inaccurate or may provide a biased review on a topic. For example, this website that discusses why the iPhone is better than the Android and the BlackBerry has an ad promoting Apple products. The article doesn't look at specs or... Finally, look at coverage. Ask yourself, how much detail is there in the content? Does the writer go in depth and provide facts and references? Does the content generalize or go into specifics? If the site touches on the topic lightly and doesn't elaborate on points or statements with facts or references, it could be an indication that you should look at the site with a more discerning eye. So let's do a recap. When evaluating a website, look for the authority of the site. Check for the accuracy of the information. Make sure the content is current. The writer is being objective. And ensure that the content has evidence or details to support statements. If you need more help, feel free to contact a librarian at your university. They are more than happy to help.